Hi, this is Diane. I'm going to show you how I created this layout by making the journal cards from scratch. For this, I used a kit by Arms Designs and masks from Joanne. I started by opening a canvas and dragging in some papers. This one. They're all here. See that? Paper, paper, paper. And then dragging in the masks. Okay. To create a pattern paper mask, you can control click on the mask here. And then go to a paper and press control J. And there you have a mask created from a pattern paper. Do it again with this one. Control J. And this one, Control J. And I have done this other masks and papers. Now you see I have all sorts of masks to start playing. To create a blank journal card, that's also very easy. Open up a paper that you like, drag in a journal card for size. Control click on the card. Control J for copy. Now I have a new card of a blank paper. So I copied it. Open new canvas. And paste. Now I have a blank journal card. I will save this journal card. Okay. Now I have a blank journal card and I can play with the mask that I created from the pattern papers. I'll go to the pattern papers, click on one of the masks and drag it into the blank journal card. Oh, that's a bit big, so I'll resize. Move it around where I want to have it. Okay, that looks good. Go again, back. Drag in and out. Out and in. See what it looks like. And another one. This one looks good too. Okay. Now I've dragged in 3 patterned paper masks to create a new artsy look journal card. If I'm happy with this one, I'll leave it at that. I have opened a new layout and copied a background paper into that. So it's just paper. Now I will drag in the newly created journal card, which is still a PSD in layers. When I drag it into a new canvas, like this, it automatically becomes just one layer. That means I won't be able to play with it anymore, but it is now a finished card in my new layout. If I want to create more cards, I just do more of the same I just already did. Drag in the prepared masks. Play a little. Move around with stuff until I have something I like. good. Wow, this. And a bit of this underneath. No, that's okay by me. That's my next journal card. I go to the layout I'm creating, drag in the PSD journal card, and that is now again a one layered journal card. Like this, I can create as many cards as I want. I have already done some others. Here's another one. Okay, and these three cards, I can line them up by like this. Now they look great on a page like this, or whatever you want. And I can save this as my new layout. I can do this as often as I want in all size journal cards until I get something like this. I now have all artsy journal cards, but still a very clean look. If you're playing with journal cards and you're not familiar with it, you can, of course, place them anywhere you want on your layout, but what I did was just copy the preview of the journal cards made by Ange. In the preview, the journal cards are lined up just like this, and it looks great, so I changed it. If you want to add more layers or more brushes to your journal card, open the other template with more brushes, or use your brush tool, and go about the same way. I'm now dragging in a brush from Courtney. That's large. Resizing it. That's okay by there. Control click. Make it invisible. Pick the color you want. It's pink instead. Okay. Create a new layer. Use your bucket tool. There you have it. This is great. Like this. And again, you can drag it into your layout. A little bit more. Or use this one. Pick your color, yellow this time. Control click, create a new layer, bucket fill, and now I've added another yellow layer. Go to my layout, and there it is again. And you can do this as often as you want to create the look you want. And then again, you end up with something like this. When you're done, you can start adding a picture, some elements, word art, whatever you want. I'm not going to show you that, but you can do that yourself. That's it. Thank you for watching.